हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अनदर डिजिटल लेक्चर क्लास 12th बिजनेस स्टडीज। इन आवर लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट लेवल्स एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। ईच पर्सन इज गिवन डिफरेंट टास्क टू अचीव द बिजनेस ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। सम राइट्स आर ग्रांटेड फॉर फुलफिलिंग The responsibilities. Officers and subordinates are formed with the given rights and responsibilities. This relationship is called levels. The number of levels of management determined by the nature of the business. The level of management is shaped like a pyramid. This shows that as the employees move from top level to lower level, the number of employees increases. Generally, the number of levels of management is determined based on the size of the business, the number of employees, the technical component, and the nature of the business, etc. Edward Francis Leopold Brecht, in his book Principles and Practice of Management, classified the levels of management into three categories: top level management, middle level management, lower level management. First, we will talk about the top level. Top level management. Top level managers are responsible for the progress and continuity of the organization. Their job is complicated and fully stressful, demanding complete dedication and commitment to organization. Top level managers are responsible for welfare and survival of the organization. In top level management, board of directors, chief executive officer, etc. are included. Chief executive officer can be a single person. Chief executive officer can be called by many names like managing director, general manager, president, etc. Top management has all the management authorities, and because of these rights, officers of these levels are responsible towards owners or shareholders of the company. Top level managers determine the objectives and implement policies. They evaluate the results. Main functions of top management. First point is to determine the objectives. The top level managers set the main objectives like expansion of business, manpower planning, etc. of the organization. Here, nature of objectives can be long term as well as short term. Top level management determines the general objective and specific objectives of the business. General objectives: business survival, profit, business growth, prestige, goodwill, social expectance, all are related to general objectives. Specific objectives: workers' specialty, competitive price, marketing method, expansion of sales area, workers, consumers, public, and government, all are related to specific objectives. Second point is to frame the policies. Top level managers also frame the plans and policies to achieve the set objectives. First policy is production policy. The aim of production policy is to produce the right product at the right time, at the right place, so that competition can be faced and the business can run for a long time. Production policy contains the schedule of production to meet the demand of market. Second policy is marketing policy. This includes channels of distribution, advertising, sales promotion, technology, etc. In this, the choice and requirement of the customer is ascertained It has to ensure long-term stability and focus on customer satisfaction. Channel of distribution means the price policy in the channel of distribution is influenced by which intermediaries the goods reach the consumer after. If the intermediaries is more, then price will be high, and if the intermediary is less, then the price will also be low. Second is advertisement. Personally informs the public about the goods and services, and it motivates the purchase them. Advertisement generates new demand. New items enter the market through advertisement. Sales promotion means this includes offers, discount, free coupons, etc. Third policy is personal policy. Personal policy refers to that policy which deals with recruitment, placement, training, remuneration, promotion, etc. of personnel. Fourth policy is financial policy. Financial policy refers to that policy which is related to raise funds. It includes source of finance, management of earning, etc. Third point is to assemble the resources. Human resources, machinery, raw material, finance, and technique, etc. are arranged by them to achieve the objectives of the organization. To collect resources and balancing 5 M's properly. 5 M's means main, machine, material, money, method. The worker should be sufficient, and the machine should be used properly, and the material should come on time, and the amount of money required should be in the proper quantity, in which method should be work be completed. All these things are included in it. Fourth point is to set up the organizational framework. The structure of the organization is finished by top management. All work is done to follow the plans, and rights are given from top officers to subordinates. Fifth point is to control operation. With the help of budget, cost, statistical quality control, and accounting, top management controls the operation of the business. Now we will discuss about middle management. Middle level management acts as a link between top management and lower management. They are mainly known as division head, means factory manager, plant superintendent, etc. They are responsible for implementing and controlling plans and strategies formulated by top management. They receive orders and instructions from top managers and get work done through lower managers. It also consists of the head of various departments like the finance manager, production manager, marketing manager, sales manager, etc. Middle management is the most difficult task because they are under pressure from both the top level management and the lower level management. Main functions of middle level management. Middle level management plays an important role. On the one hand, they have to implement the policies made by the top management. And on the other side, the emotions and reactions of the lower level management also have to be kept in mind. In such a situation, it becomes a difficult task to maintain our existence because middle management has to face both top management and lower management. First point is to explain the policy. Explanation of policies are framed by top management to lower level. Middle level management acts as link between top level management and lower level management. They only explain the main plans and policies framed by top level management to lower level management. Second point is preparing organizational setup. Generally, middle level management are the head of some departments, so they organize all the resources and activities of their department. Every middle level manager prepares outline of his related department in accordance with the objectives of the organization. Third point is appointing employees. Every departmental manager appoints employees to fulfill the activities of his department, like finding out or selecting and appointing the required employees for their department. The middle level management selects and appointing employees of their department. Fourth point is controlling and instructing the employees. The middle level management watches on the activities of lower level management. They prepare their performance assessment report. Departmental managers guide their subordinates about what to do and how they have to do it. Necessary resources are made available to subordinates so that they can do the allotted job continuously. Fifth point is motivating employees. Middle level managers motivate their employees by various means so that they can work most efficiently and achieve organizational objectives. Sixth point is creating cooperation. Cooperation among different divisions is required to successfully achieve company's objectives, and this is done by middle level managers. Lower level management. Lower level management. The bottom level of management is considered to be operative management or functional or effective or dynamic. This is mainly related to the supervision and guidance of the operative workers or functional workers. Lower level management is directly in contact with workers and salesmen. Quality is good, efficient quantity should be completed on time. Lower level management also has the responsibility of all these things. Managers of this group actually carry on the activities according to the plans and top and middle level management. Their authority is limited. The quality and quantity of output depends upon the efficiency of this level of managers. They provide the instructions to workers and report to the middle level management. They are also responsible for maintaining discipline among the workers. Main functions of lower level management. First point is submitting workers' grievances or complaints. Lower level managers are in direct contact with the workmen, who are directly engaged in the completion of work. Lower level manager sort out the ordinary problems of the workmen and submit workers' serious complaint to the middle level managers. Second point is proper working condition. Lower level managers ensure that proper arrangement of water, electricity, ventilation, cleanliness, etc. is made at the workplace. This increases efficiency, maintaining good working conditions, and developing healthy relations between superior and subordinate. The supervisory managers provide good working conditions and create supportive work conditions, which improve relations between supervisors and subordinates. Third point is ensuring safety of workers. The chances of an accident can be eliminated by building protect around machines. Supervisory level managers provide safe and secure working condition for workers. Fourth point is helping middle level management. They help middle level management. Managers in recruiting, training and promoting employees, they guide and help the middle level managers when they select and appoint employees. Fifth point is inviting suggestions. They invite suggestions from their subordinates so that the quality of work can be improved. The lower level managers encourage the workers. They reward them for good suggestions. Sixth point is maintaining quality standards. The lower level managers try to maintain good standard of quality and ensure regular flow of output. The lower level managers make sure that quality standards are maintained by the workers. Seventh point is increase the morale of workers. The lower level managers are responsible for increasing the morale of workers and developing the team spirit in them. Lower level managers motivate the employees and boost their morale. So today we understood levels and functions of management. If you have any doubt related to these topics, write below in the comment section. That's all for today. Thank you very much.